Shang-Chi is here. Courtesy of Dark Side Toys, they managed to ship this really, really quickly. So it is in stock there right now if you want to pick it up. Link in the description below. So these are epic, really good looking figures. We just get the trailer. Figures are released out there to get. That's pretty damn cool. So yeah, these are rather nice. There's a lot of nice elements in them, and the design and the sculpt, and a couple of supporting characters here as well as a bath. Let's get through them all. 7 figures to go through. We'll get through some packaging first, then get into the detail of the figures. But the facial scans, the design of them, the way the characters look, they're pretty excellent figures, it has to be said. Each one stands at roughly 6 inches, or 6 and a bit inches, which is around 16 centimetres. They're all roughly in proportion, not much really between them, with the smaller Shai Ling there being just a little bit smaller, but all pretty much in scale and looking good. And the Build-A-Figure there at the back, I didn't measure him actually, he is a rather monstrous nearly 9 inches or 22 centimetres. So each of the packaging comes with some very nice artwork on the side. As you'll see there, there's Tony. It's beautifully done. It looks John Tyler Christopher-ish, maybe? I think it is, I don't know. But I wish they made more of a fuss about that and said that, but it's pretty cool looking artwork. I don't see anything there, but each pack, if you want to freeze frame, there's some text on Tony. I won't go through the whole UPC. We've got the Marvel Legends Conquest of Champions Civil Warrior. He sits down with a cup of tea for you and a chat. But there you go. So that's the back of his packaging. And again, some very nice artwork there by, we assume, John Tyler. I think it's an integral thing they should do in all the packaging, is really mention who the artist is. This is, and there's the logo at the front of the movie-based MCU figures, Wen Wu. And again, some very nice artwork on him, a.k.a. the Mandarin. I don't think I'm spoiling that if you've seen the trailer. And there's all of the figures in the wave, I should say. All of them you pick up. And each of them, apart from, I think, Shang-Chi, comes with a part. All of them come with a part. My bad. There you go. Look at the instructions there. And that builds Mr. Hyde. And there is the text on the back if you want to read that too, which has lurked in the shadows of the MCU since the very beginning. Hint, hint, Iron Man. Shang-Chi himself, in his packaging, looking very good. He kind of looks older on the design there and the art than he actually is in character and face and on screen. And again, some text if you want to freeze frame there. And all the usual stuff, not much else to really tell you about it. Shai Ling looking beautiful in that photograph or illustration, I should say, there. And there's some text if you want to freeze frame there. Katie is an exclusive figure, so she's not included here. She's a Target US exclusive, or if you're in the UK, you can potentially get some from Zavvi. I have at this moment skipped. I was going to pick it up, but the fact they made it exclusive just made it even more awkward and pricey. And so, no, not buying it. There you go. I'll change my mind once I've seen the movie. And finally, probably my favourite of all of this, Death Dealer. Looking very good indeed. Very smooth. And again, some gorgeous artwork on the side. So, put them all together with all the spare parts and you get Mr. Hyde. Let's get a look at him first and foremost, just to be, why not? Let's have dessert first. So this guy is just ugly as. Look at that face, that incredibly monkey-like face. Obviously, I don't know much about the character, but obviously the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde. There was a Marvel comic of him, I remember that, thinking, gosh, that was a bit silly. But there you go, bowler hat included. Been up all night taking something on the old eyeballs. Nicely painted, nicely sculpted. The hair looks good. These kind of flaps, as always about the flaps, done there on the side of the figure underneath. And if we pop the head, you'll see the way that they've sculpted and designed that, which is quite clever. It's quite nicely done. It means the teeth are inset in the mouth and they're not kind of painted on. Nice engineering. That doesn't really pop out, does it? No, but it probably could if I poked it. There is some glue in there, but interesting. Just nice the way they design it, so. And his hair's quite different from his old sideburns. There's some nice sculpt on that. If that's what you're into, then you're going to be very happy. Got a nice little bow tie going on there. The suit's nicely done with the kind of tailoring around the jacket. Got all these nice sculpting on the waist. And really, there's not a great deal else to tell about on the rest of the figure. He's got very hairy knuckles. But nicely sculpted. He's even got a little wart or two on each one. A little something to get on. And the toenail, the fingernails. Look at the fingernails. They're all broken and warped. And he's got this cane, which is done in a kind of really nice gold powdered-like paint. But you can even see they've sculpted in some details in there. Some nice little subtle chips and scratches, and that is nice. Even on the shaft of it itself, there's some chips and scrapes and scratches, and attention to detail, man. They do a really good job. Even on this hand here, for the figure, you can see the kind of the marks on the palm. Again, the nails. It is beautifully designed. Very, very cool. And again, the hairy knuckles going on there. Other than that, there's not a great deal to tell you about him. It's Mr. Hyde. Articulation is kind of a ball joint on a hinge on his head. As you can see on these arms, ball joint and a hinge there. A single joint at the elbows, swivel on the wrists and back and forth. He does have an ab crunch of sorts. It's kind of buried inside there and does have a waist swivel. He's got the thigh pegs up at the top. I've barely put this thing together, so you can see it's coming apart. Which gives you that thigh swivel after that pin joint. Single joint at the knees and rocking ankles. And the other little detail I love is, look at his brogues. Used to wear these to work like decades ago. When you used to have to wear posh things to work. What a waste of time that was. But very cool indeed with these little brogues. Nice little attention to detail. And he doesn't need it, but he comes with pickles. So that is Mr. Hyde. A bit of a monster indeed. Pun. Let's get a look at Tony first, actually. The next one here. I really quite like this figure. It's just the classic Iron Man. I reviewed the 80th anniversary MCU figure. And it was rather cool indeed. And again, the really nice Tony. This is essentially a repaint, but instead of gold, it is yellow. And it's much more comic orientated. Essentially the same figure, really. Got those little side pieces as per the comic. But there's a really nice, chunky comic vibe and feel to it. It's very plain otherwise, but again, that's half the charm. Not pegless. And this translucent head here, if I get a little another light on this for you, let me pop on my torch on my beloved Pixel and we'll shine that down through the head. And there you go, you can see it doesn't really work very well, but you can see the sculpt is there. It's nicely done, perhaps as it shines through the back. Now you can't really, there's a lot of fiddling around to get the light on it correctly, but it's nicely sculpted. You really can see Tony's face in it pretty well. It's got a nice kind of sculpture of hair, tash, eyeballs. Everything's going on. Looks good. Looks the part. And it's actually one of the nicer translucent slash hologram heads or figures that I've seen, actually. I really kind of like it. They've applied a little bit of paint, a darker little bit of paint. You can maybe just see, there you go, on the goatee there. And that's accentuated that up. And I think they've done the same on certain strands of the hair at the front. So rather than leave it completely translucent, they have in fact dabbed on the eyeballs, dabbed on a blue on the tash, and on the chinny chin chin. And that has kind of helped highlight it there, really just kind of bring out the face. Otherwise it would be lost in this sea of blue plastic. So quite a nice figure. Pop that off and you can get the classic Tony head on, or Iron Man head I should say. Enjoy the carousel as I try and do this. Oh my goodness. So we'll get to Civil Warrior in a second, then get into the MCU figures. This head does not want to go on. Let me just try this again here. These are all brand new at the packet again, shipped minty fresh. And then I felt bad because I had to destroy the... I am not getting this head on. I had to destroy the boxes to get into them. I may have to work with a hairdryer on this one. This one is absolutely solid. There we go. My God. Da da da! There we go. So the other Iron Man head. It's nicely done though. Looks the part. Looks nice. Tony comes with two blasters, two blast effects, and two hands, two blast effect capable hands, and two fists. And that is him. Not a great deal to say about him. Standard articulation that will be the same on pretty much all the figures. Ball joint with a hinge up at the top there. Pretty free range in movement. Same with the arms. Mega posing on this guy. Double joint at the biceps. You'll get swivel wrists and back and forth. Ab crunch, eh, reasonable. Waist, thigh joint up at the top, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, boot cut on this guy, and rocking ankles, pec holes. Looks good though, do like him. He'll go well with the War Machine. Civil Warrior is a repaint of the gold Hydra figure that came out maybe a year and a half ago or so, as a kind of Hydra Supreme pack. So again, they've done a really nice job here in the paint. It's a complete repaint of the figure. Not a great deal else to show you about that. Again, I've given in-depth articulation and detail on that figure. But the shield, it looks very nice here indeed. It's got a really nice effect on it overall. I don't have the figure around to compare it. But what is nice, I do not remember that on any previous shield, is this. The back end of it there has been kind of completely redone, I guess, to kind of magnetize onto this Civil Warrior as he sits and has a cup of tea with you, etc. One annoying thing is the peg on the back, which I immediately went, yeah, that'll look really cool. And there's no peg. And I thought it maybe would pop out or something, kind of like the 12-inch, but I'm really surprised they didn't drill or Dremel that out for this figure, but... huh. So there you go. So you literally have that option to peg it onto his arm. His forearm. If I go on, go on. Come on. Trouble with these, and there you go. So you got a nice shield on the figure, but it's a very nice facial sculpt. It looks very robotic, paint sharp, looks good. Star looks good, the belt looks good. Nice fabric on these legs, looking very good. And that's something we'll point out in the Shang-Chi figures. And again, that's him, looks pretty solid. I do like him, he's one of the more popular ones. I think that and Tony are actually quite popular in this wave. But there you go. It seems Shang-Chi is the one that is double-packed overall. Whoops, as I throw things around here. And he is obviously the star of the movie. Now, he comes with a bunch of hands here. We've got quite a few different kind of bits that it's worth kind of looking at. Two kind of gripping hands, this one here. And this kind of, almost as if he's got a playing card in his hand. I guess that's one of the moves in the movie we've yet to see. So not really a gripping hand, a kind of snapping his fingers kind of thing. The other two hands, so there's another a dual snapping finger hand, so it's kind of like jazz hands. Well, not really, this would be jazz hands. This kind of gripping hand here is the other one, and I've got one of them in the figure. So again, two gripping, I mean, Dwight was really right about this in the panel when he was talking about this recently, where this, my God, you're going to get a lot of hands with these figures, man. So you get gripping hands, this grasping hand, and this kind of almost like a card in your hand, whatever you would call it. Pretty cool. This shaft that he comes with, this pole shaft, whatever, is, I'm sure there's a proper oriental name for it. It's got a nice little leathery looking strap at the end there, sculpted well, painted well. It's actually got a kind of like a honeycomb design on it with a gold pearlescent vibe going on in the main part. It's very solid, very thick. But yeah, he holds that pretty well. And here he is, really, just get a closer look at him. Pretty sharp. A little bit dead in the expression, I think. Now that I've seen the trailer, I'm like, a little bit more of an action pose, I think, would have, I think, benefited the figure, given all the hands and poses you potentially want on him. But it's still not bad in any way, and still very much like the character. Here is done nicely. It is not bad at all. Nicely sculpted again, the detail on that suit is phenomenal, and that's pretty much something that rings through on all the characters there, and plain right down to some kind of like sneakers with the white around them there, trainers, whatever you want to call them. It's a pretty plain figure, and I'm sure we're going to get another version of him in the MCU, another look as such. But yeah, a nicely solidly designed Shang-Chi figure. And if I have it here, here is the comic Shang-Chi, which I just adore. So I think it's a fabulous figure. Really takes you back to the 70s and Marvel Comics and that kind of style. So, and again, that same kind of gripping hand there as this one here. But cool figures nonetheless. Okay, Shai Ling is the next one up. Again, she comes with quite a bunch of hands there to swap out and use. She has Oh my god, she's got a lot. Two kind of palm hands. She again has this kind of, I guess, signature move of she's holding something. It's got to be some kind of martial arts like move or something. That kind of hand picking something. Two fists. And that is it. So two of each. So I've used, and also one, yeah, gripping hand. Ah, that's right. There's only one gripping hand. I don't know why that was a little bit odd, that one. But there's one gripping hand, and this holds this little rope set here, which is kind of nice. She's obviously gonna, I can't recall her in the trailer doing anything with that, but need to go back and watch again. Beautiful sculpting again. Beautiful line work on that transfer. It's really imprinted well onto the figure. And I think she has one of the best facial sculpts. Just beautiful. Really nicely done. Really toned down. It's not super shiny. The shine is right what it needs to be. It's beautiful. I think that is one of the most gorgeous facial sculpts we've seen in a long time in the MCU range. Very on point. Nice and matte paint, not shiny. Nice tone in the lips. Hair looks great. Our hair had a little bit more of a flare in the on the box art, which I think would have been really nice to capture, but very difficult to capture. And it means obviously you have to have it in that pose. She's the same articulation, she just doesn't have a double joint at the elbows as per the others. But pinless tech. Yeah, baby. So there you go. Another cool reason to grab her. And this beautiful display, this flow that it comes across on this sculpt. It's beautifully done, even just the ripples in the fabric there. I really appreciate the details. And look at the sharpness of that. That's spot on, man. So yes, a very cool looking character. Again, a very solid figure. Mr. Mandarin, essentially, or to correct his name, Wen Wu. Now he comes with a bunch of hands. I'm gonna get some of these mixed up. In fact, I think I did. He comes with the usual two fists, two gripping hands, and I think he had, what else did he have? A kind of, maybe that was the other hand there. My God, there's so many hands. Yes, he's got two grasping hands, and they are for this rather nice weapon here. Let me take Death Dealer off here just now, just because it's going to distract the camera. This beautiful weapon, very nice. Dwight again, yet in the panel, was showing off real life versions of these. I do not know the exact name of them, but damn, pretty impressive. Really nicely done. Very nicely done indeed. And not much else to show you on him, but a beautiful sculpt. Nice facial scan tech again. Really, really well captured, I think. But look at the fabric, the material, the design. Holy balls, it's amazing. 10 rings. It looks like a checked shirt that he's got wrapped around his waist, but it's not. But just phenomenal on the design. My God, it's beautiful. I just love the design of the fabric and all the material. Just even the little pop marks there. It's very nice. And there are the 10 rings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on each hand. So solid figure, and again, some nice material there on that kind of private protector. And boots with even nice little details on the boots. That phenomenal. I just love the detail on that. Really, really cool. Wen Wu looking very, very cool indeed, aka the Mandarin. We shall find out more in the movie. And finally, last but not least, Death Dealer is my absolute favorite. Now he, or she, I think it is, comes with two. I thought these were Deadpool hands, but they're so not. Two kind of open splayed hands there, and also comes with throwing dagger hand. Really intricately detailed on that, and one hand with the knife already stuck in it, which is really cool actually. I really do like the way they've done that. Look at the detail on this though. Intricacies tied in there, all in that fabric, all the way across the back of it. It's got the little kind of Greek key on the side there. Two knives that are plastic but molded in there, which look really nice. Shame they're not painted the bottom half of them to be silver when they are silver, so they really should be silver. Unless they're mini sheaths, that's a good point, they could be. But all the subtle details in this thing, that trim all the way around, even on the boots, this little kind of imprinted tattoo transfer, etc. I guess it's male. It's relatively flat-chested there, but the hair almost could have been female. But the facial sculpt on this character, let me just, is just phenomenal. It looks a little bit female with a flick at the end. Let me see if I can get a better look at that face for you, just to really show you the detail in the eyes. It is gorgeous. And a little bit of sculpting finally across the mouth. What a range. Pick them up at Dorkside Toys, link in the description below. Again, articulation is pretty much the same. This is quite limited because of the skirt here, but otherwise pretty much the same, and it has pins. But beautifully designed, probably one of the best waves I've seen of Marvel Legends in quite some time. Not really digging some of the other ones that are out there, the new waves with the Bear Build-A-Figure, but also some nice details underneath that bodysuit there, kind of silverish. Anyway, we'll find out more about Shang-Chi coming up soon, but yeah, let us know what you think of these reviews. This entire wave, all done and dusted, but looking very cool indeed. Again, link in the description below to buy them. Give it a likey, subscribey, all that crap, and we'll see you for more reviews coming up soon.